They are Doctor Who and the TARDIS. All you Doctor Who fans, you gotta make some noise. Doctor Who and the TARDIS. You can actually hear a screwdriver. I gotta be careful, the screwdriver's on. All right, thank you very much. One more hand, guys, one more hand. All right, next we have Ryan and Nikki Rios, Brock and Ash. Come on in, guys. Pokemon fans, here you go. And he's already ready to battle with Pikachu. Look at that, folks. He's already ready. Brock and Ash. There you go, guys. Thank you very much. And finally, we have Rain Violette Soto, and she is dressed up as Chun-Li. Here she comes. Here she comes. One more time, Chun-Li, ladies and gentlemen. All right, that was the toddler division. And now we move on to the kid division. There we go. Oh, there we go. That's what I'm talking about. Contestant, Nicholas Vasquez as another Doctor Who. Turn around, turn around and show that beautiful costume right there. Look at that, turn around, look at that. Look at that, John. Love it, love it. All right, we do have a message from the doctor, so I need to give him the mic for just a minute here. What are you going to tell us?
Well, I'm the doctor, and I'm 1,245 years old, I think.
You look very young for over 12,000 years old.
That's because I regenerate.
I love it. I love it. I love your screwdriver. Thank you very much. Nicholas Vasquez, folks. Next, we have Robert Aimaris, I hope I said that correctly, as John Egbert. Is that correct? I'm going to come over here and talk to Robert. I've known Robert for a while. How are you doing, Robert?
Good.
Tell us a little bit about your costume.
He's a human from an online webcomic called Homestuck. And so I'm cosplaying as his god tier form, which is technically his dead form.
Excellent. How long did it take you to make the costume?
It took me about 3 days, maybe four.
Alright. Sounds good, sounds good. One more time, folks. Robert's over here. Thank you very much, sir. Thank you. Okay, coming up next, in the kid division, we have Ali Ikudev Tim. I hope I said that correctly. As Elektev, okay. As Grell. Girl, how are you doing today?
I'm doing fine.
Tell us a little bit about your character.
Well, I'm a die-hard creeper.
I love it. I love it. How long did it take you to make this costume?
It took me a few months.
A few months. Okay, what was the hardest part?
It was trying to find the makeup.
Well, it looks really nice. How about coming to the front? Give him one more to step around. Here we go, folks. Girl is in the house. Thank you very much. Thank you very much. And finally, in the kid division, we have Melody Linares as Weberella. Weberella is in the house. Here we go, folks. Now, I'm very afraid of spiders, so I don't know if I should even get close to her, but I'm going to try here for a minute. How are you doing, Weberella?
Very good.
Tell us a little bit about your character. Who is this character?
My character is a monster high, and she was supposed to be the good guy, but she was actually a villain.
Spoiler, folks. There's a spoiler right there. So be careful right there, okay? How long did it take you to make this costume? Did you make it by yourself?
No, I designed it, but my parents helped me sew it and everything.
How long did it take you to make it?
About a week and a few days.
Very good. One more time. Give him a little walk right there. Weberella in the house. Thank you very much. Thank you. All right. That was the kid division. Now it gets serious, ladies and gentlemen. Now we go to the adult division. All right. All right. First of all, those of you that are comic fans might recognize this character. So we begin with Victoria Peralta, is that correct? And she is Lady Deadpool. She's dropping everything. She's okay. She's all right. Lady Deadpool, come on, come on, come on. Lady Deadpool, tell us a little bit about yourself.
I'm a merc with a mouth, and I have a sassy attitude.
I love it. I love it. How long did it take you to make this cup?
Took me about 4 or 5 days.
Okay. All right. What is the hardest part?
The mask.
The mask. And I gotta ask. Have you been getting pictures? Have people been asking for pictures?
No, not really. Only everybody.
Yeah. There we go. Ladies and gentlemen, Lady Deadpool. We have Jose de Leon, and he is dressed up as Ichigo Karasaki. Give us some pose. Give us some pose. Give us something, my friend. Give us something.
Bleach, my name is Ichigo Kusaki, substitute Soul Reaper assigned to Karakura Town. How's it going, guys?
Excellent, excellent. How long did it take you to make this costume?
Took about like a day of measuring. Bunch of fabric that I don't bother to pay for.
Very nice, excellent. Anything else you want to tell the crowd?
Well, anytime there's a holo, you'll probably see me there, so I look out for every one of you guys.
Let's have any one, folks, right here. Well, if we had a Lady Deadpool, there's a pretty good chance that we're going to have somebody else. So, ladies and gentlemen, Martin Lara as Deadpool.
Click, 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 played the money, and then now here is my costume.
Vanessa Manrique, and she is dressed up as Mituna Captor. There we go. How you doing? Who is this character and where is it?
I'm the Tuna Captor from Homestuck.
Excellent, excellent. How long did it take you to make this costume?
A few weeks.
A few weeks. Would you like to say anything to the crowd?
Yo.
There you go. There you go. One more time, the Tuna Captor, right here. All right, coming up next, we have Cassandra Perez as X-23, ladies and gentlemen. Now, you look very similar to Wolverine. What is your relation to Wolverine?
She was experimented on, and she does look up to Wolverine a lot because she feels he's like the only one who's been through what she's been through, so it's very, I guess, kind of clingy on him. And I really like the character because at first I just heard of her from Marvel vs. Capcom 3, and I didn't think of much of her. I also thought, like, oh, female Wolverine. But once I, like, read her backstory, like, she's been through a lot, and she even went through, like, serious issues that happen in real world, like prostitution and stuff. And she has a lot of flaws. She's not like the normal superhero, like female superhero. She's very human, and I also realized she has a lot of social skills problem, and like I could really relate to that. And I also saw that she was an assassin, so she knows martial arts and stuff. So I wanted to try to do a kata, a karate move. It's like a set of moves as if you're fighting like a bunch of people, so I was wondering if I could do that.
Of course, yeah. Definitely. Here we go, ladies and gentlemen, X-23.
Description of everything I use, or what?
Give us the main parts of it.
EVA foam, star foam, well, some here and there, crafting foam, and yeah.
There you go, exactly, a lot of hard work. Are you a fan of the game, I take it?
Yes, sir.
How long have you been playing the game?
Since Halo 3.
Have you played, all of them then?
Yes, sir.
Excellent, excellent. You want to do a little show again, or anything?
Toothless? Where are you? I'm completely lost. You were supposed to be here with me. Where are you? Hey, I found you. Why aren't you up here? Well then, thanks for nothing, you useless dragon.
Thank you very much. So tell us a little about this character. Who's this character and where is he from?
This is Hiccup. He's from Burke. He's from High Trainer Dragon. He's a very interesting character, very awkward person. And he's actually very smart. He's supposed to slay dragons, but instead of slaying them, he ends up befriending one, and even helps to repair one of his tail, which helps him fly. Together, they team up to pretty much save Bert from this giant dragon, and it's pretty cool.
That's awesome. I love this jacket. Did it take a long time to make, or?
It took me about a week. I learned about this con not too long ago, so I was like, pick up, and I ran for the fabric.
Do you listen to the Legacy Comics podcast?
I don't know what that is.
That's okay. That's all right. We'll tell you about the show earlier, then we can have more time. That's an awesome costume. Anything else you want to tell the group?
Hi.
That is Hiccup, folks, right there. All right, here we go. Next in the adult division, we have Alejandra Chavez as Hatsune Miku.
Oh, okay.
She's just a pink badass.
I love it. How long did it take you to make this costume?
I actually got it made by the same guy that's been doing my costumes for about 10 years. This year he was upset with me because this was kind of hard to make.
So you gave him a challenge right there. Excellent, excellent. How long have you been a fan of Star Wars?
Well, since I could sneak out of my room and watch it with my parents.
I love it. Ladies and gentlemen, right here we have Denisa Garcia. Would you like to do a show?
Actually, I needed to take a selfie with everyone in the background.
Okay, then there we go, of course. Gotta be careful, the glasses right there. Smile, everybody. Smile. Thank you very much. Thank you. All right, coming up next, we have in the adult division Jess Way as Choco Sakura. Come on in. That is awesome. How you doing? Come on, come on here to the front real quick. Now, I noticed that you're eating, is that Pocky? That looks like Pocky.
Yum, yum.
Oh yeah, there you go. Tell us about your character and where is this character from?
It's from Boeya Marie Mauka Magica. It's Kyoko Sakura. She's a magical girl who fights against witches, but she was kind of died for his friends that betrayed her.
How long did it take you to make this costume?
4 months.
4 months. What was the hardest part?
The weapon.
The weapon. All right. Would you like to do a show or anything, or would you like to say anything?
That you don't waste food.
Don't waste your food. There you go, folks. Thank you very much. All right. Coming up next in the adult division, we have Denise De Leon as Honora Akemi. Come on in. That is awesome. Come on, come over to the front. Tell us a little bit about the character. Where is it?
I don't speak English.
You don't speak English? Okay, that's okay. That's all right. Ladies and gentlemen, we don't want to embarrass anybody, so again, one more time. Let's give it up right here. And because, hey, look, we are on the border. I think we all understand anyway, right?
Yep.
In Espanol, what is it?
Que.
Okay. See, that's right with our MC 101. Ask them the question first, right? All right. In it.
Honora Akemi de Madoka Magica.
I'm going to have trouble with my Spanish now. Right? I'm having trouble with Spanish. ¿Cuánto tiempo es para hacerlo?
Alrededor de 2 meses.
2 meses, 2 months. All right. It is beautiful. Thank you very much. Gracias. There you go, folks. In the adult division, coming up next, we have Cruz Pizano Jr. as Usopp. Come in.
Oh, Usopp. Ah, con madre.
That's awesome. Come on, Denise. Come over here, sir. Come on. That's right. Who is this character and where is it from?
Usopp from One Piece.
Excellent, excellent. Tell us a little bit about what was the hardest part of making this.
Growing my hair.
There you go, right there. Folks, one more time. Usopp right here. Next, we have Christy Arredondo as Sakuya Izayoi. Come on in.
Ah.
Hajime mashite. Come on in. Come on in. How are we doing? What is this character and where is it?
Toho.
Toho, nice. Okay, now did you make this costume or did you have some help with it? Oh, 大丈夫. 私は, Nihongo. 大丈夫. めっちゃうまい。うまい。はい、はい。 Japanese again. That's awesome. I lived in Japan for 4 years, so that's why. That's why. Alright. Alright, coming up next is Frank Gonzalez as Connor Kenway. Come on in. I'm going to be very careful with you. I want to be very careful. This is an awesome costume. Tell us a little about this character. Where is it from?
My character is Connor Kenway. I'm from Assassin's Creed 3. Basically, the story is an Indian, and it's during the Revolutionary Era. It's fighting with the British people, so I've met a pigeon in Washington.
That's awesome. That's awesome. I got to tell you about this costume. This is incredible. Folks, look at this right here for just a minute. How long did it take you to make this costume?
It took me 3 months.
What are the hardest part about it?
The pets.
The pets. That's awesome. Now, I take it you are familiar with the game. Have you played all the games or just this one that you really like?
No, I've been all of
them. That's awesome. One more time, folks, right here. Connor Kenway. And Jerry Jimenez as Sailor Moon and Tuxedo Mask. Contest, right?
That is correct.
Well, I'm glad you did it. There you go. Ladies and gentlemen, Zatanna! And now, humans, be careful. Coming up next in the adult division, we have Sandra Martinez as The Terminator. Look at this, come on in, come over here. Terminator, folks, right here. Now, it actually does look awesome, it's weird. Obviously, the toughest part was the makeup. How long did it take you to put the makeup?
Probably less than
2 hours. Less than 2 hours, wow, okay. And is this a particular Terminator, or just made up a Terminator?
Just a regular Terminator.
Awesome, very nice, very nice. The Terminator, ladies and gentlemen. Take a short little break while the judges look at all of the contestants, check their scores and so forth. I do want to go ahead and remind you that any cosplayers that are out there that were not in the contest, if you please stop in at the Yowza booth outside afterwards to kind of get your picture taken, of course, and to get some record for, you know, for the memories, of course. So that'll be after the contest. So for right now, we're going to let the judges count the scores and just kind of relax for right now, folks. Thank you.